Carbohydrates, or carbs, are one of the three macronutrients that our body requires to function effectively. While carbs have recently had a bad rep as the cause of excessive weight gain, there are a lot of good carbs out there. In this video, we are going to be learning about what are the good carbs that we can eat and how much carbs should our diet have. This video is brought to you by Kaya. Most of us fail to achieve our fitness goal because as we get busy, we get distracted with other things and start missing our workouts. Download Kaya and never miss your workouts again. There are a variety of carbohydrates that humans consume, which vary in terms of the variety of micronutrients, the glycemic index rating, and the density of calories per serving. A particular carbohydrate can be good or bad for you depending on these properties. Carbohydrates are the primary source of energy to our body. When we eat them, they are digested and broken down into glucose and then transported and distributed as needed by our body. Some functions, such as vision, are only able to derive energy from sugar sources as opposed to fat or protein, which can also be metabolized into energy. As a result, carbohydrates are essential for our survival. The problem with carbs arises when we consume more than the body actually needs. When we have excess glucose in the system, our body stores it as fat for later use. Glycemic index of carbs. Glycemic index rating, or GI rating, describes the rate at which a certain food is absorbed by the body. Foods with a higher GI rating will be processed rapidly and provide your body energy instantly. However, they will spike your blood sugar levels and make you feel hungry again quickly. Food with low GI ratings are digested slowly and therefore will make you feel full longer. Depending on an individual's situation, higher or lower glycemic index carbs both may be appropriate. An athlete running a race may want to consume high GI foods immediately before a race to have instant energy available to do the hard work. A diabetic, on the other hand, may decide to consume low GI foods to prevent diabetic attack from occurring. What are good carbs? When choosing carbohydrates, you should be aware of what are good carbs. A good carb source is filled with a variety of micronutrients, minerals, and vitamins, and has a low glycemic index rating. When you think of carbs, potatoes, rice, and pasta come to our mind. However, not many of us realize that fruits and vegetables also fall into the carb category. The lowest glycemic index carbs are the vegetables. Most of the vegetables are very high in antioxidants, vitamins, iron, while containing very few calories per serving. Fruits have relatively higher amounts of calories and also provide a lot of micronutrients. However, the calories from fruit are also not sufficient for normal functioning of the body. If you're looking to lose weight, then fruits and vegetables are a good carbs for you. However, if you do hard work, then good carbs for you are whole grains and beans, which will provide you much needed energy. Whole grains and beans are packed with good quality calories and are also a good source of micronutrients. Moreover, due to their low glycemic index, they are digested slowly and do not raise the blood sugar level. You feel more satisfied after eating these carbs and do not get hungry again. Bad carbs. The simple carbs, such as sugar, refined flour, and white rice, are considered bad carbs. They are low in nutrients and high in glycemic index. You can eat a lot of them without feeling satisfied. When your diet mainly contains simple carbs, you end up consuming a lot more calories than what you need. This eventually leads to weight gain, obesity, heart disease, high blood pressure, and type 2 diabetes. Unfortunately, these are the carbs that constitute a major part of a modern diet. How much carbs should you eat? The amount of carbohydrates that we should eat is dependent on what your goal is. If you are bulking up and trying to gain muscle, then carbs should make up 40 to 60% of your total daily calories. If you are trying to maintain weight, then carbs should make up about 30 to 50% of your daily calories. While if you are trying to cut fat, then carbs should constitute 10 to 30% of your total daily calories. No matter the goal, always make sure that the carbs you are eating are all coming from sources of good carbs. In the recent times, carbohydrates have received a lot of bad reputation. Everybody seems to be going on a low-carb diet. Keep in mind, carbohydrates are not your enemy. They are an essential macronutrient that your body needs to function normally. It is the highly processed carbs, which are low in nutrients and high in glycemic index, which are the problem. If you are aware of what the good carbs are and only include them in your diet, and also according to your daily calorie needs, you should be totally fine with carbs. This concludes our video on carbohydrates. For next week, we are going to be talking about fats. Thank you for watching this video. Click the like button if you enjoyed watching our video. Subscribe to our channel if you want to learn more on fitness. We have a lot of exciting stuff coming up for you. Let us know what you think about this video in the comments. We would love to hear your opinion. Have a great week ahead, and we'll see you next week.